Hello everyone, it's Seth, probably better known as Saffron Olive, and it's time for another Instant Deck Tech. So as you know, Tuesday means it's Type 2 or Standard Tuesday, and this week we got a really sweet mid-rangey Abzan deck to check out. I'm calling it Abzan Excavator. It's kind of like Abzan mid-rangey slash ramp slash planeswalkers, but it looks really, really sweet and plays a lot of cool cards, has some neat synergies. Comes to us from Blackmaster24, who took it to a 5-0 finish in a competitive Standard League on Magic Online, so congrats to Blackmaster on a really sweet deck. A quick reminder before we break down Abzan Excavator for Standard. If you enjoy this deck and you want to see it made into videos, take a minute, click the like button, the subscribe button, leave a comment, anything you can do to support your deck, because whichever deck is most popular gets a shot at being made into videos next week. So Abzan Excavator kind of starts off with the creature base. So the idea of this deck is to play just a ton of really good value-y cards that are also like sort of ramping us and synergizing in less than traditional ways. So in our 2-drop slot, we have Merfolk Branchwalker and Seeker Squire, and these cards are actually very similar in our deck. They're kind of inverted. The black one is a 1/2, Branchwalker is a 2/1, but they both explore when they enter the battlefield. So this starts us kind of just churning through our deck. If we get a land, great, make sure we get our land drops. If we don't get a land, we can mill over something we don't want and then make our creature a little bit bigger. So just good value-centric 2-drops, which lead us up to kind of the big land plan, which is super awesome. So Wayward Swordtooth is a card that I have seen in so many decks. This is maybe the single most popular card for Fishbowl Thursday decks that people submit, but most of them don't really have a good plan of using Wayward Swordtooth. So the trick of Wayward Swordtooth is you really got to have a way to make sure you're hitting your extra land drops for it to really do anything. Just sitting out there hoping you have an extra land in hand isn't good enough. You really want to be playing 2 lands a turn. So the solution to this problem in Abzan Excavator is Ramunap Excavator. So Ramunap Excavator allows us to play lands from our graveyard. Wayward Swordtooth lets us play 2 lands a turn, which means we can play 2 lands from our graveyard, which really helps us ramp super fast because we have a lot of synergies with getting lands in our graveyard. So first off, straightforward with Excavator, and remember with Swordtooth we can do this twice. We have 4 Evolving Wilds, 1 Field of Ruin. So Evolving Wilds, really simple. We got Excavator, we got Swordtooth, we Evolving Wilds, we crack it, we get a basic land, we get Evolving Wilds back from our graveyard, we crack it, we get another basic land. So we're basically ramping twice a turn and thinning the lands out of our deck. Field of Ruins works the same way as long as our opponent has a non-basic and we have the mana to activate it. But there are lands that keep going to our graveyard, coming back from our graveyard. Apart from the Evolving Wilds and Field of Ruin, we also have a sweet desert package. So Heshep Oasis, Ifnir Deadlands, we just sack them for value, pumping our creatures, killing our opponent's creatures. And then the super sweet addition, only a one of, but is Dunes of the Dead, which is a desert that actively wants to be sacrificed. When it goes to the graveyard from the battlefield, we get a 2/2 zombie token. So we can just keep sacking the Dunes of the Dead to our Deadlands, to our Oasis, getting it back with Ramunap Excavator, maybe even twice a turn in the late game. So this is kind of like a weird Todd Stevens value town in modern type deck. But for Standard, the same type of synergy where you're playing multiple land drops a turn from your graveyard and using those lands to grind out value. Since we're talking about the lands, we might as well finish off the mana base real quick. Scavenger Grounds, good for Scarab Gods and God Pharaoh's Gift. Worth noting, doesn't actually work well with Excavator because it's exiling itself. It's going to be in the graveyard when it exiles everything. So it doesn't actually keep coming back from the graveyard. So keep that in mind. Arch of Araska, way to draw some cards. Blooming Marsh, Concealed Courtyard, it duels a bunch of basics. Since we're so focused on lands, we also have Hour of Promise. We're not really a ramp deck. We're just playing Hour of Promise more for the tutor ability. Like, getting our 2 best lands, Arch of Araska, Field of Ruin, let's say, depending on the situation, while also getting a couple of zombies for 5 mana is actually a really good deal, even though our curve is ending basically at 6 mana. We don't have anything super, super expensive. We kind of top off with some planeswalkers. So how are we actually finishing the game? Walking Ballista is kind of number one. Make a bunch of mana, keep making our land drops. We can cast Walking Ballista for all of our mana, ping our opponent a bunch, shoot down their creatures. Just a really good finisher because we can play it on turn 2 just to kill a Glintsleeve Siphoner or Earthshaker Kenra, and then in the late game we can spend 10 mana and make it a 5-5 and have it be 5 damage to our opponent's face, put counters on it as the game goes along. Otherwise, we got a bunch of planeswalkers for closing out the game. Liliana works really well with our explorer creatures because we can mill over our Ramunap Excavators, our explorer creatures, whatever creatures with the explorer mechanic, then reanimate them. Plus Liliana just gets lands in our graveyard, so it's helping set up the Ramunap Excavator synergies with Wayward Swordtooth by milling over lands, giving us zombies along the way. Johnny churns through our deck, kills creatures, finishes the game with the ultimate, and then Voraska, super, super strong, lets us kill things like Anointed Procession, which can be pretty annoying, Heart of Kirin, those annoying things, as well as creatures, make a bunch of pirates while plusing, and then the ultimate gets our opponent to one life, should be able to figure out a way to get in that last point of damage. Removal-wise, Fatal Push for the early game, Voraska's Contempt, and Ixalan Binding to deal with those annoying mid-game creatures, Scarab Gods, Hazarets, all that kind of stuff, Planeswalkers as well. We talked about the mana base, so let's talk sideboard. This is kind of our control package from the sideboard. Carnage Tyrant, really hard to deal with outside of Settle the Wreckage or other sweepers, so a good way to come in and steal games against opponents that are playing really removal-heavy decks, but leaning on Voraska's Contempts, Castouts, rather than the sweeper effects. Nissa, Vital Force, is another really good grindy card in control matchups, plus at once get the ultimate. As we're playing our two lands a turn, we're drawing two cards a turn. With all the land synergies, I almost wouldn't mind the Nissa being in the main deck, because it's really easy to ultimate, and then it's super, super strong with two lands a turn, not even counting Evolving Wilds. Like, imagine two Evolving Wilds from the graveyard each turn, fetching up two lands and drawing four cards a turn for free with the Nissa ultimate. Lost Legacy, primarily for Approach of the Second Suns. Doomfall, kind of walking the line, giving us an expensive Thought Seize, an expensive Edict. Then for aggro, we have Moment of Craving, gains us some life, kills a Danto Vanguards and all the early game creatures. Deathgore Scavenger can come in against aggro to gain life, also against graveyard decks. Yahani's Expertise is our sweeper. Naturalize for artifacts and enchantments, and that is Abzan Excavator for standard. And that's our instant deck for today. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I will talk to you soon. Thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed it, help us out by clicking that like button down below. And to keep up on all the latest and greatest, click that subscribe button. And don't forget to hit that bell icon to get alerts whenever we have new videos. And if you want to, check out some of our other sweet videos here and here.